Nearly East Nashgrass played here for this fall will be 6 years, and they've asked me to host the Guild a couple different times, and this being the third, and I'm very happy and honored to each and every time that we get to. So how about another big hand for Dee's Country Cocktail Lounge? This is such a great place, and it was a pretty new bar when we started, and they took a chance on us, and we sure do thank them for that. And we've been able to bring some really great artists here over the years as guests and different things, and tonight is no exception. I'm really excited about this fella that's over here with the banjo. If you ever look up there on stage in one of those country bands and you see a guy playing every different instrument on stage and singing every part, he's probably a bluegrasser. And in the case of the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, that was certainly this man right here. And he's done everything and met everybody and done all the cool shit that there is to do, it seems like. And he's still out there doing it, and I can't thank him enough for being here tonight. Y'all make welcome the one and only Mr. John McEwen.
Thank you, James.
Oh, this is a little close. Oh, well.
Hi, my name's John. I'll be out here in a minute. Okay, I'm here. Get the banjo. A bunch of nice people here. I started playing the banjo years ago, kind of like. I started playing it actually in Orange County, California. 17 years old. And over the years, I had a lot of kids come along. And when my daughter was 5 years old, I remember her asking me one night, "Daddy, would you play me a song on the banjo so I can go night-night? Isn't that sweet?" And I tucked her into bed and sure, honey, night-night. She'll be out of therapy in one more year. But I didn't know what to play, so I went into the house, and this song was coming out of television, and my parents were watching TV like they usually did. And maybe some of you recognize this ballad from years ago, a ballad on the banjo. Kind of corny to play this song at a bluegrass thing, but I think people like it. In fact, I think they know it, and I think you're going to sing along with it if I ask you to, so sing along with it. I'm asking you to. Let's hear you. Listen to my song. See? Yeah, the black gold, the real stuff, not that fracking stuff, no. That's a good word. You can say it in church on Sunday, though. Hey, Bob, that's a nice fracking car you got there. Yeah. Sounds like a 60s therapy session in here. Let's finish off. Ready? Next thing you know. You know what's weird about that? It's a bluegrass tune, and everybody knows it. And I don't think any of you know the whole national anthem. Clap along. Thank you. you know, I have a lot of, Corey Walker is a great banjo player. And he's just, if you haven't heard him play before, you're in for a treat. Whoops. Uh-huh. Oh, great. Yeah, we can know it. But could you turn this up a little bit, please? Yeah, a little bit more. A lot of people ask me, is it hard to play the banjo? And I said, well, anybody can do this. Anybody can do that. Anybody can. And you can play a melody. And anybody can do this. See, it's just one. But if you do them together. Something unusual. You know, when I started playing, I wanted to learn something that was musical, something that people could maybe relate to. And this is something I think would, I've worked this up especially for the kind of place that I'm in tonight. My dad told me when I was starting to play, he said, you know, you're going to end up playing in bars. But this one's okay. He was right. I'm gonna sit down and play this one. You're an awful nice, quiet crowd for a bar. I appreciate that. And this is a song that I played years ago. And I'll see how it goes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's get the band up here. Corey. I'm going to do some music with everybody. I appreciate you listening to that. It was a wonderful thing that I got to do. And I wish I knew. How did this thing get... How many people here are fans of the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band? All right, that's me too. As the band assembles. You probably know I am a pilgrim, don't you?
What key?
F. F be a good one? You familiar with an album called Will the Circle Be Unbroken? That was an album that started, well, it actually started in Boulder, Colorado. Boulder, Colorado, when I asked Earl Scruggs if he'd record with the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. That was taking him back to a club one night. And I was really nervous about it, but he said, I'd be proud to. A week later, I asked Doc Watson, he was playing the same club. I asked him if he wanted to join us and Earl on an album. So it sounds good to me. On the next Monday, my brother asked Merle Travis. We played with Merle Travis at the Ash Grove in L.A., our first important L.A. job, 1966. No, this is the time when the music on the radio was things like... No.
Wasn't like that.
Or it was things like... You know, John Fogerty's going to start singing. But my favorite one... This is a really hip crowd you have here, you know? This is... My favorite one, I'll just play you a part of the lick. You'll know what it is. Isn't that cool? Remember that one? Oh, maybe I should play a little more. Tambourines too. It's like, but that's what was out there. Are you guys ready? Key of F. Merle Travis, I Am a Pilgrim. I am a pilgrim and a stranger. Traveling through this wearisome land, I've got a home in yonder city. Good Lord, and it's not made by man. Well, I've got a mother and a sister who have gone to that sweet home. I just pray that I can go and see them, good Lord, over on that other shore. Get it. Phil. If I could touch but just a hem of his garments, good Lord, I believe he can make me whole. Now, when I'm dead, laying in my coffin, all of my friends. Both of my friends all gathered round. They will say that he is laying there sleeping. Good Lord, sweet Pete, his soul is found. I'm a pilgrim and a stranger traveling through wearsome land. This ain't a wearsome land. But there was a time with the nitty-gritty dirt band, we went to a wearsome land. You know, the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band was the first group, first American group, to go to Russia. We did 28 shows. It was a great time. I traded a pair of Levi's for a house and a car. Yeah. Play it out. I've got a home in that yonder city. Good Lord, and it's not made by man. From somebody out there that was wanted to hear something from the Dirt Band album, Uncle Charlie and His Dog Teddy. This is the first record that we put out on that album, and it made it to the top 30. And it went over so good that we had to put it out again to convince us to put that out again. It'll do better. Well, this time it made it to the top 20. And it's in the key of E. Got to tell the band we're rehearsing right now. And Jimmy Ibbotson sang it. And I was awful glad of that because he took this Mike Nesmith song out to a bunch of people, like right over there. Ready? There we go. The reason why you must leave. Tell me once more why you're sure you don't need me. Tell me again, but I don't think you'll convince me. You said about falling in love again, you'd rather be dead. When someone breaks your heart, you cry your eyes red. There's nothing so hard about the life that you've led. As far as I can see, there's no reason for goodbye. You're just running scared, and that's something I won't buy. So you lose, I won't let you go. There's nothing to show but more blues. All this talk about leaving is strictly bad news. So you settle down and stay with the boy that loves you. I'll get mandolin. You're just running scared, and that's something I won't buy. So you lose, I won't let you go. There's nothing to show but more blues. All this talk about leaving is strictly bad news. So you settle down and stay with the boy that loves you. Yeah, you settle down and stay with the boy that loves you. Play it out. Thank you. We were recording that song on this album that we were rehearsing for. We rehearsed 5 months to 8 or 10 hours a day for 6 days a week. We had to. We weren't any good. It was like 1969, and we were only had been a band for 3 years, and we needed another song. One guy heard a song, and he came into the rehearsal the next day and said, "I heard a song on the radio that's perfect for me. It's about a guy with a dead dog." Sounds exciting. He a dog. Jimmy Epperson said, "I've got that in my record collection in the trunk of my car." He was all excited. He ran out to his car, a Dodge Dart that he'd driven all the way from Philadelphia to LA to be in the music business. And he made it. His entire record collection was 145. A girl had given it to him saying, "I think this will be important to your career." It was a Jerry Jeff Walker song that sounded kind of like this. I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you in worn-out shoes, silver hair and ragged shirt and baggy pants. I did the old soft shoe. Oh, he could jump so high, higher than anybody before or since. Then he'd lightly touch down. You know what I'm... Why, he was Mr. Bojangles. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance, dance on that fiddle. Folks at minstrel shows and county fairs everywhere he could throughout the South, and spoke with cheers about all those years that little puppy dog and him while they traveled about. Yeah, they did. I met him in a cell in New Orleans. He was down and out. He looked at me to be the eyes of age. Then he spoke right out. Oh, he talked of his life, what a life he had had. Somebody said, "Who is that old man?" I told him, "Well, that's Mr. Bojangles. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance." Folks at minstrel shows and county fairs, like I said, everywhere he could throughout the South. And he spoke with tears about all those years that little dog in him. Oh, they traveled about. It was tears because one day that constant companion of his, that little puppy dog, he up and died. For 20 years that old man grieved. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Bojangles dance. Yeah, I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you. And thanks to Jerry Jeff Walker and the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, he danced for all of us. Thank you. That was a great song. It was wonderful to be part of it. Wanted to get us to Carnegie Hall, and we got to Carnegie Hall before it was a hit, so that was kind of weird, but we wanted a top 10 record, but it only made it to number 15, and the record company said, it's going to go down, it's over. It had been on the charts for 15, 16 weeks, and it made it to 15. The next week, it went to 17. We figured they were right, but the next week, it went to 13. We said, it's not over. And you've never heard anyone say, hey, we have a top 13 record. Well, is there anything we can do to get it to the top 10? Well, you could play, you could do, you could play a certain girls' school in Lower Manhattan. Oh, really? Why is that? Well, Rick Sklar programmed ABC, and his daughter went to that school. So there we were, 9 a.m, setting up at the junior high Catholic girls' school to do a show. We had just played the night before and got it done at 2 a.m. So here we are, and then the sister walks in and says, boys, do you need anything? I said, well, you know, I was wondering, sister, who else has played your show for the junior high girls? Oh, this year we've had Aretha Franklin and, the Jackson 5. That was really good. And Mr. Paul Simon. And early in the year, that British boy, John Lennon. Oh, really? Well, we have an important show to do. We went up and did the show, and Rick Sklar's daughter was there, and the next Monday on ABC, now if ABC didn't play a record, Boston wouldn't play it, Cincinnati and a bunch of other stations wouldn't play it because they followed ABC. So you had to have ABC, and they said on Monday, here's a new song by the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. Yeah, and it went like this. I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you. And it made it to the top 10. Oh, you can hold it up. Hold it down for that. Let's try a song that they don't know. This is from an old Hank Williams Sr. recording. It's kind of a serious song. I'll kick it off.
Yeah, I think. That's a good idea.
Did you ever sit straight up in bed with something circling around your head? You swat it is, it whizzes by, and it's just one pesky little fly. You shake your head and twist your nose, settle down to sweet repose. Then when you're just about to doze, fly trouble. Buzz, buzz, buzz goes that busy little fly. Buzz, 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 he's taking off and high. So you roll the paper nice and tight, wait around for him to light. But there's a fly that's living right. Buzz, buzz, buzz. Sweet. Well, the toughest hide grows on a mule. He's a balky, stubborn fool. Likes to look at you and glare and never even move a hair. But when that muscle starts to twitch and when that old tail begins to switch, well, that mule, he ain't bothered with an itch. Fly trouble. Buzz, buzz, buzz goes that busy little pest. Buzz, 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 that mule don't get no rest. He shakes his head, bats his eye, and kicks his heels up to the sky. You ever see a jazzhack cry? Buzz, buzz, buzz. So you pick a perfect night in June. The flowers are blooming neath the moon. Your light of love is burning bright. You tell yourself, tonight's the night. You brace yourself and your courage grows. You get down on your knees. You're gonna propose. If something bites you on the nose, fly trouble. Buzz, buzz, buzz goes that busy little thing. Buzz, 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 you swat and lose the ring. You fan the air as he goes by and stick your finger right in your eye. Hit everything except that fly. Buzz, buzz, buzz. I'll play it. Yeah, man. We know that one for the next time. Let's go back to that Circle album, and Maybelle Carter brought a song into that that I wanted to do from the first time I heard the Carter family. I heard their music on a Flat and Scruggs album recorded in 1964. And Doc Watson asked Maybelle if she knew the ending on that old song, and she says, well, I don't know, but I started it like this. There's a dark and a troubled side of life. There's a bright and a sunny side too. Though we meet with the darkness and strife, may the sunny side always come to you. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life.
Come on.
It will help us every day. It will brighten all our way if we keep on the sunny side of life.
Play it.
Fury broke today, crushing hopes that we all held so dear. Clouds and storms in time will pass away. The sun again will shine bright and clear.
Help me out.
Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day.
I bet they know it. Let's hear you.
Keep. It will help us. If we keep on the sunny side of life. Well, you sang really good on that. I'd like to do one more song here, a bluegrass tune that got me into bluegrass. It came from Earl Scruggs and his other guy, Lester Flatt. Well, we could. This is the strange bluegrass tune that doesn't have the words of the title in the song, kind of like some of Shelley's blues. Hush falls over the crowd. This reminds me of somewhere. I don't know where, but it's like I've been a lot of places. In fact, a couple of years ago, I took a river trip in Germany, a riverboat. It went stopped at 7 cities. It was really incredible. It's one of the towns was a little town where they first bred the German Shepherd. You had to start somewhere, right? It was a little German town called Offenbarken. Are you guys ready yet?
I think so.
Ready.
Any questions?
No questions.
Yep.
There's a well-beaten path on this old mountainside where I wander. When I was a lad, there I wandered alone to the place I call home in those blue ridge hills far away. Oh, I love those hills of old Virginia, from those blue ridge hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on the mountain far away near my blue ridge mountain home?
Oh, yeah.
My thoughts wander back to the ramshackle shack in those blue ridge hills far away. There my mother and dad are laid there to rest. They're sleeping in peace together there. Oh, I love those hills of old Virginia. From those blue ridge hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on the mountain far away? My Blue Ridge Mountain home. I've been longing for days gone by. When I die, won't you bury me on that old mountainside? Make my resting place upon the hill so high. Oh, I love those hills of old Virginia. From those Blue Ridge Hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on a mountain far away near my Blue Ridge Mountain home? Hills of old Virginia, from those Blue Ridge Hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on the mountain far away near my Blue Ridge Mountain home? Far away near my Blue Ridge Mountain home.
Let's do Earl's breakdown. I'll give you the stage back, okay? Thanks for listening over the years and for here tonight. I appreciate it.
I'll give it up for Mr. John McEwen right here.
Thank you.
All right, guys. We got some more music coming up here in the Madison Guild, so don't go nowhere. Well, thank you guys all for sticking around. How many of you guys are still here in mind, body, and spirit? How many of you guys are only here in body? I love that. How many of you guys are questioning if any of us are here? Okay, all right, I won't go any longer. This next act for the Madison Guild, I'm very proud to have with us here. She's a super talented gal. She can write, she can play, she can sing, she can play banjo, guitar. If she was from my family, her name is Brenna, but if she was from my family, it'd be pronounced Brenner. So I affectionately call her Brenner. But why don't y'all make welcome over here from Kentucky, right here at the Madison Guild, Miss Brenna McMillan.
Dilly-dally down the hallway, walking to his room. Mama said that Daddy won't be home this afternoon. Tilting sideways like a seesaw, he plays an airplane game. Nothing says somebody's coming back like a game. Taking off again, high up in the wind. He's always been a flyer, he won't come back again. Do 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 do. Leaves are falling as the cold front moves into Detroit. He remembers what his daddy told him as a boy. Sometimes fathers can't make all the love inside them show. Nothing's got a hold on people when it's time to go. Taking off again, high up in the wind. He's always been a flyer, he won't come back again. Taking off again, high up in the wind. He's always been a flyer, he won't come back again. Do 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 do. Growing old, he carries on his shoulders way up high all the burdens that his dear old mother left behind. Soon enough he won't have to feel the weight of childhood. Soon enough it'll fade away when darkness comes for good. Taking off again, flying in the wind. He's always been a flyer, he won't come back again. Taking off again, high up in the wind. He's always been a flyer, he won't come back again.
Thank you. That one's about flying around and being a little bit of a restless wanderer and all that. I'm going to switch to banjo, so... talk amongst yourselves. Well, if you're from, if you live in a different place than where you're born, then you kind of understand how it is. You just get this like righteous indignation when you go back home and stuff's different, even though you don't live there, so it doesn't matter. And my parents moved from my childhood home, so now I go back and it's all different. It's weird. So I wrote this one about that.
This ain't the house that I grew up in.
when I sit here with the blues. It feels strange and empty now, leaving with no memories to lose. No memories to lose. Sun settles in the distance, old places here have closed. New buildings all around them, distilleries and townhomes in rows. Townhomes in rows. I used to live here, but I don't anymore. A lot of things have changed from what they were before. Keep holding on to the memories so dear. Outside looks the same. I wonder if they kept the old doorknobs, and I wish things wouldn't change. I wish they'd stay the same. I used to live here, but I don't anymore. A lot of things have changed from what they were before. Keep holding on to the memories so dear. Watching really old movies, and so I had to check out. Netflix has done like an Anne of Green Gables cover, so I was watching through to make sure they did it according to the book and according to all the old, you know, traditions in that book and everything. And then there was this quote in there, and then I wrote this song about that. And sure, they weren't the first to say it, but I guess it's called "Grief is the Price You Pay for Love."
Thank you.
Well, mental health, everybody's got it. Some people have it better than others. I wrote this about loving somebody who doesn't have it very good. We all have people like that in our lives, I suppose. Dark in your eyes, you try so hard to fight. I know you will. I know you're holding on for dear life. I keep hoping it'll be alright. Adelaide, I don't think that you heard me when I tried to say, please don't push me away. Someday you'll feel better, Adelaide. You may never know the way to let it go, to leave it all behind. I wish that I could send it down the line, if that would buy you some time. Oh, Adelaide, I don't think that you heard me when I had to say, please don't push me away. Someday you'll feel better, Adelaide. Standing with you here, good and bad is clear. Both are part of us. We don't have it easy, but we have love. We have love. Oh, Adelaide, I don't think that you heard me when I tried to say, please don't push me away. Someday you'll feel better, Adelaide. Adelaide, I don't think that you heard me when I have to say three words that I can never change. I love you, Adelaide. I think I'm going to get my friend Maddie up here to sing this last one with me and play a little fiddle. That'll be nice. It's not really that fun to be up here by yourself sometimes, but I had fun.
How about it for, well, hey, how about it for Brenna McMillan playing you some original music all by herself?
This is one that I wrote. I lived for like a year over here close to John Hartford's house, and then there was like all these tornadoes, and John Hartford plus tornadoes made me write this one, I guess.
Thank you.
takes two kinds of weather to bring conditions together, make a rainbow willing to shine. That keeps things real simple. There's peace to the riddle. The pot of gold's still hard to find. Together, make a rainbow willing to shine. That keeps things real simple. But there's a piece to the riddle. The pot of gold's still hard to find. There's much more to life than what meets the eye. There's decades to change and to be. There's all kinds of love that we're told to dream of. There's love to have, love to set free. It takes two kinds of weather to bring conditions together, make a rainbow willing to shine. That keeps things real simple, but there's a piece to the riddle. The pot of gold's still hard to find. Well, the pot of gold is still hard to find.
Nowhere. Our buddy Tristan Scroggins is up next with more tunes.
louder here. And you get fucked up.
Well, hey, look, thank you guys for standing around here to the very end of the Madison Guild. I'll ask again, how many of you guys are here? How many of you guys are very much questioning your own existence? That's good. You should always be questioning that. Are we really anywhere? Is any of this happening, Harry? Is this even Monday? What the fuck? Is anything even going on? I don't know. I'm so glad that this next act is right here. I could name every one of these pickers as some of my favorites right here. There's some really spectacular musicians from that side of the stage to this. I know you guys are going to enjoy this. This is our last act for the night. We got a hard stop at 11 here. We're going to be out of here. But one more time, can we hear it for D's Country Cocktail Lounge, giving us a great place to come here and gather, break bread for the Madison Guild. Thank you guys for sticking around. Y'all make welcome my friends. This is my buddy Tristan Scroggins and company.
Be my own, but now you've gone so far away and left me all alone. Another man has won your hand and took you away from me, but you still linger in my heart and in my memory. You're the girl of my dreams, but it seems that my dreams will never come true. Thank you. Could I have a little less vocal on the in the mic? Thanks so much. It's lots of fun getting to play some bluegrass. I do it for a living, but that feels different than this somehow. I don't know that I've ever actually led a set of my own, but I'm really happy to have some
really great musicians and friends with me. Including one of my best friends in the world. He helped me move here many years ago. I don't drink anymore, but I used to drink then, and the night before we left Denver, we went to a cabaret, and I drank so much gin, we had to leave a lot of my stuff in Colorado because I couldn't move the next day. But he's a great singer and songwriter and writer, many other things. This is Justin Hiltner on the banjo. We're going to do a song, a sort of California classic. I just forgot the name of the guy that wrote it, and I feel bad about it. It's called In the City.
Well, I'm going home again. I just can't remember when times were good like they were then. In the city, man, you just can't win. I've been drinking every day just to run my blues away. Again, in the city, man, you just can't win. There's a girl that I know. She lives out on Berry Road. Pour her sweet love again. In the city, man, you just can't win. I can't do right all the time. I'm inclined to change my mind. Moving on, times again. In the city, man, you just can't win. Well, I'm going home again. I just can't remember when times were good like they were then. In the city, man, you just can't win. In the city, man, you just can't win.
Thank you. Rich Wilbur, that's the guy, California songwriter. I heard it from Spectrum, though. Great band from 40 years ago.
Listen to it. Watch.
Great.
which is Jeep. And it's my kind of old-time engine.
So we're going to do a little instrumental number now, a little favorite old-time tune of mine. And I'll introduce the bass player here. He's in one of my favorite bands in Nashville right now called Dallas Ugly. He's a really excellent bass player, and he was on this crazy project that I did a couple years ago where we played, we recorded 100 fiddle tunes in one day, and this was one of those tunes, but would you make him welcome? This is Eli Broxham on the bass. This is called Lost Girl. Thank you. He's playing guitar for you here. This is his first ever guitar gig. And he's... Woo! He's a great musician, and he's a really excellent fiddle player and a great guitar player. I should have said also excellent. It sounded like that was less than... I didn't mean it that way. He's a good friend. We used to play in a band together. Would you make him... He currently plays with Sarah Hull. Would you make him welcome? This is Avery Merritt. We're going to do a song that's kind of dumb. You know, I love bluegrass a lot. I think about it literally all the time. I listen to it constantly. I feel like people are really afraid to talk about how dumb a lot of it is. And we're going to do a really dumb song that I love a lot now called You Don't Think About Me When I'm Gone.
One, two, three.
Now you don't think about me when I'm gone. You don't think about me when I'm gone. When I come rolling home with those $10 bills, it's honey, where you've been so long. I've been all around this whole wide world, been down to sunny Alabama. Well, any old place that I hang my hat is home sweet home to me. Now you don't think about me when I'm gone. You don't think about me when I'm gone. When I come rolling home with those $10 bills, it's honey, where you've been so long. Pretty girl, shoes that you wear so fine. Got my dress and my hat from a railroad man, my shoes from a driver in the mines. Now you don't think about me when I'm gone. You don't think about me when I'm gone. When I come rolling home with those $10 bills, it's honey, where you've been so long. We've been from. I'm gone. When I come rolling home with those $10 bills, it's honey, where you've been so long. It's honey, where you've been so long. Thank you. Playing the fiddle. Oh, it's not in. Oh, it's okay. Playing the fiddle. I've known her for a long time. She's such a great musician. It's so much fun getting to play with her. Did you win twice?
You win last week?
Yeah. She's a two-time IBMA Fiddle Player of the Year. Yeah! Give her a hand. This is Bronwyn Keith Hines. Yeah! all of this is pretty last minute. I was gonna play with a friend of mine, but then she was exposed to COVID, so I had to put together some friends real quickly. And I asked them all yesterday, except for Bronwyn, who I asked like an hour ago. So we're gonna do a love song now, sort of a love song. I mean, in that it's sort of about love, but lost love. It's a very passive-aggressive song. It's, I'd like to send it out to, well, you know who you are.
Do you guys know this one? Yeah. You know this one?
Like the five-star stuff.
No.
Don't feel blue when I tell you I'm leaving. Please don't cry, dear, when I set you free. For I know that my heart will be breaking. I'll get by, don't you cry over me. When the cold rain is falling outside, dear, and you're happy far over the sea, don't be thinking of me. Don't you shed any tears, they'll be wasted, for our love was never meant to be. That's why I don't want you to worry. I'll get by, don't you cry over me. When the cold rain is falling outside, dear, and you're happy far over the sea, don't be thinking of me. Time you weren't happy, that someday I'd have to set you free. That's why I don't want you to worry, 'cause I'll get by, don't you cry over me. When the cold rain is falling outside, dear, and you're happy far over the sea, don't be thinking of me and my sorrow. I'll get by, don't you cry over me. I'll get by, don't you cry over me.
Thank you.
Good job.
Oh. Will we leave you now?
Yeah, sure. I'll do it for 2 minutes. It's so much fun playing with people. It's been a long time. I grew up in New Mexico, and there is a bluegrass history in New Mexico, but not much of one. And so I didn't have a lot of people to play with growing up. And I also, you know, was weird because I was playing the mandolin. And so, I don't know, I spent a lot of time just like playing music alone. And I worked up a bunch of things that I thought sounded good alone. And one of them is this, I got really into Jesse McReynolds stuff. Jesse was great, still alive, lives here still. Great mandolin player and innovator, did lots of really amazing things. And I was listening to his playing and I kind of modified some of it to be more like, well, I always wanted to play the banjo. I'm not smart enough to play the banjo, but I can sort of do it on the mandolin. So I'm gonna do a little old time tune called Cumberland Gap. Thanks. So during the lockdown, I went a little bit crazy. I was living in an Airbnb that didn't have a kitchen or windows. So that wasn't great. But I had recently gotten a tenor banjo, and I made this little tenor banjo EP, just, you know, like five songs. And I put it out on cassette, because I figured no one was going to buy it anyways. So I put it out on cassette, and I should have probably brought some. I didn't, though. And this one doesn't involve tenor banjo. It's the one I was like, I can't have just all tenor banjo. So this is an old protest song that I've heard on this Smithsonian collection of protest songs, specifically like labor movement songs. And it was about the meat packing industry, which, especially, you know, if you recall during the lockdown, people working in meat packing plants were getting COVID a lot because they were like forcing them in these pretty bad conditions. So it remains prescient 60 years later. Sorry, I didn't tell the sound guy I was going to do this. Early in the morning at the start of the day, I forced my fingers round the handle of the blade, starting a cutting just as fast as I can. By the end of the day, I can hardly move my hands. Got that old carpal tunnel in my hands, won't move, but the foreman tells me to stay in the groove,
Cut that cattle as fast as I do, you'll get that carpal tunnel too. Well, I work with a knife and a blade in my hand. I cut them cows with a big iron band. It feels like a knife is cutting me all the time. 'Cause the carpal tunnel lives in the big nerve line. Got that old carpal tunnel and my hands won't move, but the foreman tells me to stay in the groove. Cut that cattle as fast as I do, you'll get that carpal tunnel too. Well, I work with a knife and a blade in my hand. I cut them cows with a big iron band. Feels like a knife is cutting me all the time. It's the curse of the speed up on the carcass line. Got that old carpal tunnel and my hands won't move, but the foreman tells me to stay in the groove. Cut that cattle as fast as I do, you'll get that carpal tunnel too. Going for an operation once more, but I'll come right back to the killing floor. Tell those darling children of mine, don't you ever go to work on the carpet house line. Got that old carpal tunnel and my hands won't move, but the foreman tells me to stay in the groove. Cut that cattle as fast as I do, you'll get that carpal tunnel too. Cut that cattle as fast as I do. Got that old carpal tunnel and my hands won't move.
Thank you. I'll invite my band back up and we'll play a couple more songs.
Thanks.
One for Mayday.
Oh, yeah. Do you want to sing something, Justin?
I can if you want me to.
Or something?
Do we want to do a slow one?
I can do a slow one.
Let's do rose-colored glasses. An A?
A.
Not sure how this one works.
Familiar with the rose-colored?
Lots of fours and fives.
Justin's gonna sing you a number here. It's a good one.
It's not true.
Yeah, you cry a lot.
Yeah.
You cancer.
Here's one I call, that's called I'll Never Shed Another Tear.
You call it that.
I call it that too. One, two, three. Darling, for I thought you meant the world to me. But now you have gone, and I have been forgotten. so I'll never shed another tear. I'll never shed another tear. No, I don't care what happens. You have proved your love untrue to me. There's nothing you can do that would ever change my feelings. So I'll never shed another tear. Told me, dear, that you were only fooling. Then I never would have learned to love you so. And that I wouldn't have all this heartache, my darling, dreading the day I'd see you go. I'll never shed another tear. No, I don't care what happens. You have proved your love untrue to me. There's nothing you can do that would ever change my feelings. So I'll never shed another tear. Play it, Bronwyn. Those vows we made together, many times you told me not to fear. But now you have gone and you've left me here forever. So I'll never shed another tear. I'll never shed another tear. No, I don't care what happens. You have proved your love untrue to me. There's nothing you can do that would ever change my feelings. So I'll never shed another tear. I'll never shed another tear. No, I don't care what happens. You have proved your love untrue to me. That would ever change my feelings. So I'll never shed another tear. So I'll never shed another tear.
That's Justin Hiltner.
Five-star head.
Exactly. Oh, let's do one more. I don't really want to do it all three.
What's a better tune?
B. All right, so we're going to do, sure.
Huh? We were going to, and then we decided against it.
Not enough of us knew it.
What do we think about it?
Yeah, what do you think
about it? It's a
classic.
Great song.
Who wants to do it? Time honored.
Well, we were going to do it, but now we got to do one more, and then we're done.
It's my fault. I didn't know it.
Yeah, we didn't all know it.
That's okay. That's not your fault. Learn it for next time.
Listen, love, it's not your fault.
Well,
it kind of
is.
You know what?
Take
the
blame.
It's
all right.
I'll put on my rose-colored glasses.
And the words
of blur. That's right. Well, it's been great fun playing for you folks. I'd like for you to give a big hand to James Key for hosting the Mass and Guild tonight. And also to our great sound man, whose name I've unfortunately... What was your name?
Will.
Will is doing a very great job. It's very good.
How about Tristan Scroggins, everybody? Our favorite.
That's great. I don't really play around town. I should probably, but I play with Missy Raines. That's my kind of thing I do a lot. I'm on the internet. You can find me on the internet. Just don't look too hard. We're going to do one called Wrong Road Again, which I think is a pretty universal sort of feeling. Just keep making that same decision.
How do we... I guess I'll kick it off unless you would say
that's a good idea.
You got it.
I was trying to sing it an octave higher than I can, but now I know what to do. I can't seem to learn not to love you. You get to me every time. You're someone I just can't say no to. You're so good at changing my mind. Here I go down that wrong road again. Going back where I've already been. Even though I know where it will end. Here I go down that wrong road again. You're weaving, you and those soft, easy lines. Before I can stop, I'm believing you're so good at changing my mind. Here I go down that wrong road again, going back where I've already been. Even though I know where it will end, here I go down that wrong road again.
Scroggins, everybody.
Yeah, that's great.